Hello. May I welcome you to our worship for this Good Friday here at St. Martin in the Bullring. I greet you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let's pray together. Lord Jesus Christ, you invited all who love you, all who sincerely desire to be your disciples, to follow you right to the cross. So now we stand in fellowship with you, with one another, and with all your people in every place and every time. Lord Jesus, we remember your death on the cross, and we worship you. We come to remember your anguish in the Garden of Gethsemane as you faced the awful, awesome cost of your calling alone. Lord Jesus, we remember your death on the cross, and we worship you. We come to remember your arrest and brutal interrogation, your sorrow and humiliation, your suffering and your death. Lord Jesus, we remember your death on the cross, and we worship you. We come to remember your quiet acceptance of human evil and hatred directed against you, you who had done no evil and knew no hate. Lord Jesus, we remember your death on the cross, and we worship you. Lord Jesus Christ, we remember your great love, and we marvel at how much you were willing to suffer for our sake. Lord Jesus, we remember your death on the cross, and so we praise, thank, and worship you with all our heart, mind, and soul. Amen.
Lord, for me. The reading is taken from Luke chapter 23, beginning at verse 32. Two others, both criminals, were led out to be executed with him. When they came to a place called the Skull, they nailed him to the cross, and the criminals were also crucified, one on his right and one on his left. Jesus said, "Father, forgive them, for they don't know what they are doing." And the soldiers gambled for his clothes by throwing dice. The crowd watched and the leaders scoffed. "He saved others," they said. "Let him save himself, if he really is God's Messiah, the chosen one." The soldiers mocked him too by offering him a drink of sour wine. They called out to him, "If you are the King of the Jews, save yourself." A sign was fastened above him with these words, "This is the King of the Jews." One of the criminals hanging beside him scoffed. "So you're the Messiah, are you? Prove it by saving yourself and us too while you're at it." But the other criminal protested, "Don't you fear God even when you have been sentenced to die? We deserve to die for our crimes, but this man hasn't done anything wrong." And then he said, "Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom." And Jesus replied, "I assure you, today you will be with me in paradise." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
It's understandable why people outside the church and outside the Christian faith would wonder why on earth we would call today Good Friday. Because at the heart of this day is the cross. And although for many people now the cross is merely a piece of jewellery they wear or some artwork inked into their skin, it was originally, of course, a means of execution to instill terror on all those who would defy the power of the Roman Empire. The Romans seemed to have an obsession with power, a love of power. And of course, the cross was designed to actually destroy any who might oppose or threaten that power that they had. It was a means of destruction. Equally, it was designed for all those who were walking by, all those who were onlookers, to fill them with any sense of doubt, to fill them with fear as they looked at the people hanging there and the suffering that they endured. It was deliberately designed to instill a deep sense of horror, all in order to reinforce the power that the Roman Empire claimed to have over their subjects. The emperor seemed to have all authority. For the person hanging on the cross, because it demonstrated and recognized that they were supposedly guilty of some sort of sin or crime. The person up there had committed a great wrong, and that is why they were left to hang in shame. Of course, it was also designed to cause incredible pain and suffering for the people who were there. It was ultimately a symbol of hate. And of course, it was designed to bring around a very slow, a very protracted, and very painful death. So why on earth would we call today Good Friday? Well, of course, for those of us who know Jesus as our Lord, recognize him as our Savior, and believe him to be the Son of God, we see the cross in a very different way. Because for us, it doesn't demonstrate the love of power, but rather it demonstrates the power of love, particularly the power of God's love to change lives, to change the world, to change your life and to change my life. For instead of being a means of destruction, the cross becomes a means of restoration. Restoration between us and God, and restoration between each other. In place of doubt, the cross becomes a symbol of our faith in God, and our hope in Jesus Christ. So therefore, instead of horror, the cross becomes a symbol of deep, profound joy and rejoicing. For Christians, we also believe it's a means by which we receive salvation. We believe that actually it wasn't Jesus' own guilt that was demonstrated on the cross, but our guilt. It was our sin that nailed him to the cross. So that instead of guilt and sin, you and I find freedom and forgiveness. And in place of our shame, we receive honour. Honour as we are enabled to become children of the living God through the death of Christ on the cross. Instead of suffering, it is a symbol of wholeness, freedom from sin, pain, suffering, and death. For instead of death, the cross represents life. And ultimately, instead of hate, the cross brings love. And that is why we believe today is Good Friday.
Save us, love to me, love to the Lord.
As we kneel before the cross, let us pray. Lord Jesus, we feel the burden of Good Friday, for we know that on this day you suffered, bled, and died for us. For our sin, Lord, forgive us. In our weakness, Lord, strengthen us. We are totally unable to earn or merit your forgiveness and your renewing love. We can only recall with wonder your sacrifice and seek you with repentance and faith. For our sin, Lord, forgive us. In our weakness, Lord, strengthen us. Lord Jesus, as we follow you down the road to Calvary, guide us to become active participants, not curious bystanders. Lord Jesus, as we stand with the mourners at the cross, give us the love that can forgive those who sin against us. Lord Jesus, as we witness the new life given to us through your resurrection and forgiveness, empower us with faith to spread the good news. Amen. And for the present crisis that engulfs our country and the world, we pray, keep us, good Lord, under the shadow of your mercy. Sustain and support the anxious. Be with those who care for the sick, and lift up all who are brought low, that we may find comfort, knowing that nothing can separate us from your love. In Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. As our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Most merciful God, by the death and resurrection of your Son Jesus Christ, you delivered and saved the world. Grant that by faith in him who suffered on the cross, we may triumph in the power of his victory. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. Amen.